During his absolutely bonkers interview with Elon Musk on Twitter on Monday night, Donald Trump actually admitted something that could, stressing the word could, not will, but could, end up literally landing him in jail. Here is what Donald Trump said that legal experts immediately flagged as showing that Donald Trump is clearly a flight risk. Trump said, quote, "If something happens with this election, which would be a horror show, we'll meet the next time in Venezuela because it'll be a far safer place to meet than our country. Okay, so we'll go. You and I will go and we'll have a meeting and dinner in Venezuela." Now, there is more. There's a little more context and I'm going to read you that in a minute. But here's the thing. Donald Trump is currently out on bail. Okay? He is a convicted felon that is awaiting sentencing on September 18th, because yes, that is still on the docket, has not changed yet. It may, but it hasn't yet. So if any of these other places, including New York where he was convicted, but if any of them decide that, hey, this statement means Donald Trump is a flight risk, they can go to the judge, including in places where he's only been indicted. They can go to the courts and say, listen, this man is threatening to leave the country if he doesn't win this year's election. Our trial is not going to take place before the election. We're afraid at this point he's a flight risk. I mean, because if we look at the polls right now, he's not winning this election. He could flee the country before we're able to prosecute him. He could flee the country before we're able to sentence him. We want to have his bond revoked. This statement, even with the additional context I'm about to give you, could easily be seen by a court as a threat that Donald Trump knows if he doesn't win the election, jail is already likely his next stop. So he is telling us he is going to leave the country. Yeah, I think that's a pretty easy case to make in court. But as I said, there's a little bit of extra context here because Trump did continue. He said, talking of Venezuela, "The crime rate is coming down and our crime rate is going through the roof." That's a lie. Before I continue, let me point out that is a lie. The crime rate in the United States is actually going down and has been for the last year and a half. And it's so simple. And you haven't seen anything yet because these people have come into our country and they're just getting acclimated. And they don't know about being politically correct, law enforcement or lack of law enforcement in our police. I have to just end with this. We have great police. I'll tell you what, Venezuela has not gotten rid of all of them. They've gotten rid of about 70% of their really bad people. Their jails are about 50% put into the United States. Same with the other countries, over 30%. Some are at 50%. They're all different. But the bottom line is they're all going to be 100%. Why wouldn't you put 100% of it? Now, aside from that being an insane statement that is completely based in Donald Trump's fantasy world, it also makes no sense. Like, his sentences, the words he's saying, do not make sense. Because Donald Trump's trying to cover up what he said. That's why it doesn't make sense. That's why it's not rooted in reality. Because Donald Trump's not thinking of going to Venezuela because, oh, well, they've sent their bad people here, so their country must be nice. No, the reason Venezuela's crime rate is actually falling is not because they've sent everybody here. There is literally no evidence to back up any of those claims that Trump makes. They're not emptying their jails and sending them here. They're not emptying their insane asylums, as Trump says, and sending them here. That has not happened. Nobody can provide a shred of evidence from any country to suggest that has happened. But the reason the crime rate has fallen in Venezuela is, of course, because the economic conditions of the country have become so bad that they have seen millions of people leave the country. So fewer people, less crime, because nobody is there. So it's a horrible story, by the way, for the people of Venezuela. I'm not trying to make light of that at all, but millions, at least 4 million, I think is the official number, have fled the country due to the fact that the economic conditions are so just horrible for them. So that is why the country says the crime rate has fallen, because people are just leaving us and we don't know what to do. But Trump caught himself, right? I think that's what this whole thing is about. He knew that saying, hey, if I lose the election, I'm heading to Venezuela. I think it dawned on him at that moment that, oh, crap, if I say that, that actually could be used against me in court. So let me go on this really weird rant that, again, is riddled with falsehoods, but maybe it'll save me from having one of these prosecutors go in front of a judge and tell them to revoke my bond. Let's be very clear about something. Donald Trump, as an alleged billionaire, has the means to flee the country. I mean, as somebody who cozied up to dictators while he was the president of the United States, he could go to a country that is definitely not going to extradite him to the United States. He could go live a nice lifestyle in Saudi Arabia. He could go be buddy-buddy with Kim Jong-un and play golf with him all the time. He could have the room right next door to Vladimir Putin. None of those folks would extradite Donald Trump back to the United States for prosecution and possible imprisonment. Not to mention any other country that doesn't have extradition agreements with the United States. Trump has the resources available, including his own plane, to get down there pretty easily and set up a very nice retirement lifestyle for himself. And that is what prosecutors have to take into consideration at this point. When he threatens to leave the country if he does not win the election, it's not because he thinks the country is going to go to hell. I mean, even a worst case scenario where the country kind of does go to hell, the wealthy are still going to be fine. Like, Donald Trump is not going to be in any kind of problem if 10 million people come across the border tomorrow. He will be fine in his gated community, as will every other wealthy person in this country. The only threat to Donald Trump is coming from within our court system. That is what he is afraid of. He's not afraid of migrants. He's not afraid of climate change. He is not afraid of any of the things he says could hurt this country if he loses the election and Democrats take over. No. He is afraid of going to jail. That is why he is threatening to go to Venezuela. So I guess we kind of have a choice to make, right? Would we rather have Donald Trump in America, but in jail, or have Donald Trump gone from the country forever, but a free man, right? That's a toss-up. I'll be honest with you. You know, if Trump just left America forever, never stepped foot on our soil ever again, gave up all the comforts, his businesses, everything, but he's a free man. Or he stays here and possibly goes to jail for, I don't know, 6 months, maybe 2 years, whatever. I don't know which one I would actually want. Like, if I had to make that choice, I'm kind of leaning towards just go away forever, right? I will waive you going to jail if you just leave the country forever. So Trump, I will accept your offer for you to flee to Venezuela if you do not win the 2024 election. We have a deal, so you can do that. Now, the actual prosecutors working on your cases, they may disagree because I have no authority. So if you're planning on fleeing the country, you may want to run it by a legal team first, just to make sure you don't get your bond revoked. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.